And you see, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Exactly what I've been saying all season long. Matter of fact, the last several years, okay, since I've been up, okay, you Eagle fans are crazy. Now you come on my page yesterday before our game started, after yours ended, talking crap to me. I mean, let me figure this out. You hound the Cowboys all season long for playing beating teams that are under 500, and they ain't jack shit. They ain't beat nobody over 500, okay? Then you got a quarterback, you got a team that just beat defeated the last two games, teams who are 5-20 combined for the season so far. 5-20 combined before you played them, all right? Coming off a three-game losing streak with the same quarterback you now call clutch with those two teams, the Giants and the Redskins. All of a sudden now, he is so great, he's clutch. But the Cowboys beat him, it's because we suck.
Scriptures for lost souls in the crossroads, to the corner thugs hustling for cars that cost dough, to the big dogs living large, taking it light, pushing big toys, getting nice, join your life is what you make.
Hello everybody, I'm Cowboys Legends for Life, coming back at you again with another video with my host. Did you like the last one? And I take it, but these fucking Eagle fans are be fucking crazy. Like this, what's his name, Solar Victor Solar, goddamn Derek Scott. Call him Derek Scott, but I call him Derek Scott. And if you got others like that, keep coming on my channel, talking shit because they won. You won against the Giants and the Redskins. Two of the worst teams, not just in our division. Two of the worst teams in the NFC. Okay? With a guy they call Danny Dimes, who won't have a nickel in his pocket. Okay? Then you beat him, and then you had to turn around, you had to beat the old man, Eli Manning, who you had to come back from behind. Why? You talk about clutch. Your quarterback put them in a hole in the first place. Wasn't last night he just fucking did three fumbles? He did three fumbles and lost only one, which saved his ass. Okay? Talk about, so he came back with a good clutch when he gets that deep, man. He's great, man. He's a clutch player now. So now he's got six come from behind wins. And all of a sudden, he's the most clutch quarterback you ever seen. He's a franchise quarterback. You see, I came back into those two sorry teams. No. Those are the two sorry teams that we played. Y'all said we ain't shit that we beat them for. Right? Listen. Ain't no hiding now, motherfuckers. Next week is next week. You'll be playing the Dallas Cowboys. You'll be playing Dak Prescott. And if he wins this fucking Sunday, it will be five straight wins against the Eagles alone. Five straight wins. What do you think was going to happen if that defense played last night, show up next week against the Eagles? Huh? Listen, I'm fooling myself. I'm pissed off at the Hot Boys. I'm pissed off at the Purgers, okay? The Purge Squad. You know why? Because they played like as if they were in Hollywood the entire season. They're the ones who lost most of these games. Now they're going to decide to show up. I'm hoping they show up. But I do know one thing. You ain't beating the offense. Y'all ain't stopping it off because your defense sucks. Period. I'm not even worried about our defense. Your defense fucking sucks, okay? And your quarterback will not be able to save your ass on this one. Okay, I told you before, I'm going to keep telling you. Okay? What am I going to say? What am I about to say? Go ahead and say it. You can say it for me. Okay, you don't want to say it, I'll say it. Carson Wentz can't beat Dak Prescott. How many times you heard me say it in the last several years? Can't beat him. Won't beat him. Not this season, he won't. He may get a chance down the line, like I said, in a couple of years, seasons from now. But right now, can't that shit. Your team's too fucking sorry, all right? Now, here's how I see it. Cowboys win next week. They become 8-7, and they're shooing to become 8-8 for the season. They won the division. I'll accept that. But if they do lose to the Eagles, I don't even want them in the playoffs. Because the Eagles are going to win it anyway. But I don't want the Cowboys nowhere near a playoff. They wouldn't deserve it. But you can forget about it. Carson Wentz ain't beating Dak Prescott, son. Not this season. It's another sweep, okay? I'm going to tell you straight. Why all of a sudden that, you know, well, you Cowboys, you know, well, the Cowboys are now, like Joey Shakes talking about some Cowboys are just, well, they beat the Rams now. Everybody think they okay now. They're cool and everything. And you're talking to us. Look at the teams you've defeated this season. Because, yeah, you beat a couple of teams that were over 500. We beat the Rams over 500, okay? But the Rams will take your asses apart, and you know it. The Rams will take your asses apart. The Rams had to come through us several times in the last three games they played us. They had to play us tough. They had to come from behind to beat us. Okay, in those first two games. This time they got blew the fuck out like they're supposed to be blown out. All right? I'm going to tell you straight, bro. I'm not even trying to trip about this game because I'm still pissed off about this season. Because it can go either way in my mental state about what the Cowboys did this season. Jerry Jones and Jason Garrett both can go straight to hell. Okay? But I'm with my boys. I'm with my boys no matter what. All right? And I'm going to tell you straight. Okay? Don't count on winning every fucking Sunday. And all the shit talking y'all be doing. You just beat the Giants and the Eagles. I'm sorry, the Giants and the Redskins. You just beat those two. That's all. Two teams who have a combined record of 5-20 when you fucking play them. Okay? 2-10 and 3-10. Okay? Carson Wentz had to come back from winning because he put y'all in the fucking hole in the first place. Because he sucks. He's not as good as you think he is. He got paid elite money for an average quarterback. And it still angers me. It still fucking angers me. It does. You know why? Because Dak don't have a contract yet. And he's beating everybody anyway. Okay? Anyway, I'm not gonna ramble. I'm just kind of pissed off how, and it's about 7 minutes right now, but I'm going to tell you straight out, all right? Stop fucking coming to my page bragging, motherfuckers, okay? Your team ain't shit. It'll take another couple of years before your team get back to the form it was in 2017.
Now that I escape, sleep, walk away. Yeah. Those who correlate know the world ain't kick. Jail bars ain't golden gates. Those who fake, they break. When they meet their 400-pound mate, if I could rule the world, everyone would have a gun in the ghetto, of course. When get the up and on their horse, kick around, drinking.